largest in the world.
Namaskar sir. Sir, our center is fly ash. Thermal power station.
Fly ash
और सर हम फ्लाई ऐश का इस्तेमाल जो कि लगभग 220 मिलियन टन पर ईयर हो रहा है और सर जो 94 में जो फ्लाई ऐश का सिनेरियो था वो था इट इज़ ए टॉक्सिक मटेरियल. हम दो तरह की सर प्रोडक्ट्स लेके आए हैं. एक तो सर हम मिट्टी में मिला के नहीं नहीं सर दिस इज क्लियर फ्लाई ऐश पेंट. और सर हमने महाराष्ट्र में 28 ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम दिए क्लियर फ्लाई ऐश के ऊपर.
और चूँकि
सर महाराष्ट्र डिपेंड कि सॉइल में क्या है, लेकिन महाराष्ट्र में हम 66% तक जो है सॉइल का रिप्लेसमेंट फ्लाई ऐश से कर पाए. और जिस एरिया में सॉइल की क्वालिटी अच्छी नहीं है वहाँ पे हम इस टाइप की फ्लाई ऐश ब्रिक्स को प्रोपेगेट करते हैं. इसमें कंपोजिशन होता है फ्लाई ऐश, सैंड, लाइम और लिटिल बिट जिप्सम. और जहाँ पे सीमेंट की अच्छी क्वालिटी नहीं है वहाँ पे हम लाइम प्रोपेगेट करते हैं या हम सीमेंट को प्रोपेगेट करते हैं. और सर जो 94 का सिनेरियो था कि फ्लाई ऐश इज ए टॉक्सिक मटेरियल, नाउ वी कंसीडर इट एज ए रिसोर्स मटेरियल कमिंग आउट फ्रॉम थर्मल पावर प्लांट्स. और इसके अलावा
पूरा फ्लाई ऐश और क्या क्या है
सर? इसमें लगभग 80% हमारा फ्लाई ऐश होता है, 8-10% सीमेंट होता है, 5% जिप्सम होता है और 5% अराउंड सैंड.
Shri Ravi Singh, Secretary General and CEO, WWF India, and Dr. Anandi Subramanian, Senior Economic Advisor, Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. It is organized by Ministry of Environment, Forest and ENVIS. Is a central sector scheme set up in the center.
And that is a first. That's a first in a series of firsts. Evaluation workshop. I'm happy to share with you that there are prior commitments, but there again with Kamadenu by our side, Institute to WWF ENVIS Center. Most of them have brought their exhibits to showcase their amazing range of work.
It is in the time that we are in where knowledge is available.
So ladies and gentlemen, once again put your hands together on the launch of the ENVIS portal as I invite Mr. Rajneesh, National Program Coordinator, ENVIS, and Ms. Afia, Senior Information Officer.
Please put your hands together to welcome him.
Ravi Singh ji, Lavasa ji, Subramanian madam, I am very happy today to see the efforts of ENVIS over the years and the result of it. And you say this is the first national workshop?
First time in Delhi.
But then last year I missed one thing. After coming to power, now we are practically now 2 years. But last year I missed your workshop.
It was not in Delhi, sir.
But I would have gone there. You did not call me. Because I believe that this is even the exhibition which was cramped here. But from tomorrow it will be in the ministry, and I have instructed madam that immediately issue advertisement in the newspapers so that people, researchers, students, those who are interested to see things, what are happening, they will come and visit. Otherwise what we do, hum khana purti karte hai lekin uska purpose jo hai, atma hai. वो आत्मा हम नहीं ढूंढते. इट्स ऑल अबाउट पीपल. इट्स अबाउट रीचिंग टू द पीपल, रीचिंग टू द रियल कंसर्न पीपल. एंड दैट्स द पर्पज ऑफ ऑल आवर एफर्ट्स इन एनवायरमेंट. एनवायरमेंट इज सच अ वास्ट सब्जेक्ट. Diversity is the essence of nature. And in India, we have tremendous diversity. We have Himalaya. We have 5,500 kilometers of coastline. We have more than 1,300 islands. Area, coastal area of which, if calculated, is thousands of kilometers. We have deserts in two states. We have western and eastern ghat. We have plains, Ganga and others, Brahmaputra, riverbeds. We have tremendous forest in 10 states. So you don't find all such diversity in one country. And we have a land which is bahuprasava. Char char bar main abhi Sundarban gaya tha. Chautha fasal aata hai. Four crops in a year. It's rare in the world. World grows monocrop, or tropical countries only grow some sort of double or triple. But we can grow even four crops. So India is specially endowed by nature. And we have diversity, biodiversity also. So many species, flora and fauna. Though we have 2.5% of the world's land mass and only 4% of natural water resources or natural rain, still we have 8% of biodiversity of the world. That shows a tremendous scope of environment in India. And as Secretary was saying, our whole life ethos, Indian life ethos, is based on nature-friendly life pattern. It's a sustainable lifestyle. It lives with nature because we believe in concept of Vyashti, Samashti, Srushti, Parmeshti. Vyashti is person, Samashti is community, Srushti is the whole nature. Akash, Prithvi, Jala, Vayu, Agni. With these five elements, the nature as it is, we are also part of it. The animals, flora, fauna and everything is part of it. And it is tremendous variety, it's a diversity. And therefore I said that diversity is the essence of nature. And respecting diversity is very important. And therefore, we have to preserve that diversity. We have to take care of nature and also ensure development. That's why the best word which has come after years of efforts is sustainable development. My predecessor minister once criticized me. He has every right in democracy to criticize me. He said that environment minister should not talk of development at all. Should not talk of development. I don't believe in it. I believe that sustainable development is the way out. We can preserve nature, protect nature, and also ensure growth. You can't make people starve. You can't make people live in perpetual poverty. You have to prosper. They have aspirations. And therefore, they must grow. But the growth has to be a sustainable way, where you don't destroy the nature. And therefore, we came out with a slogan, development without destruction. So that without destroying, you can develop. It's in synthesis. Ek Sanskrit mein bada achha shabd hai, do shabd hai, dohan aur shoshan. Jo gaay ka doodh aata hai, wo pehle bachhade ko pilane ke baad, aapko lena hai, that's dohan. लेकिन मशीन लगा के बछड़े को भी पिलाएंगे नहीं और खून का बूंद आने तक उसको चूसेंगे, दैट शोषण. And we must ensure that we can live with nature, we can preserve nature. I'll tell yet another example. Sustainable development by preserving nature. Delhi Metro. Delhi Metro, when it was, the project was launched, when the first station was to be built, naturally some trees would have to be cut. There was UN cry, there were PILs, there were NGO calls that, oh, don't cut trees, Delhi will go, if you are building 200 stations, what will happen? What happened? Today we have more than 200 stations. More than 50% of trees grown were replanted with the new technologies. You uproot the whole tree, take it to the new spot, put it, and more than 90% of such trees are live. And which need to be cut, those more than 5 were planted in the space of 1. And you have more greenery, and also you have public transport for 20 million people a day. 2 million people a day. So that's a huge thing. So you can have development and also take care of nature. मैं हमेशा कहता हूँ कि संगीत में भी प्रोसेस क्या है, नाद और ताल से संगीत बनता है, लेकिन नाद भी आघात से पैदा होता है. आप अगर ऐसा करोगे नहीं तो नाद आएगा ही नहीं, साउंड आएगा ही नहीं. तो आघात कोई कहेगा डिस्ट्रक्शन है तो नहीं है. सस्टेनेबल वे ऑफ डेवलपमेंट है, वो सस्टेनेबल वे है कि जिस तरीके से यह आघात नेचुरल प्रोसेस का भी हिस्सा है. एंड देयरफॉर वी नीड टू कीप ऑल डाइवर्सिटी, प्रिजर्व डाइवर्सिटी एंड ऑल्सो इंश्योर ग्रोथ. दैट्स व्हाट I always believe that is our philosophy under which we are working. As far as ENVIS work is concerned, I was amazed to see, I saw first time the exhibition, and this water, air, noise, toxic chemicals, occupational and environmental health, Western Ghat ecology, mangroves, coral reefs, lagoons, faunal biodiversity, environmental problems of mining, hazardous waste, Himalayan ecology, floral biodiversity, forestry, wildlife protected area management, ecotourism, combating desertification, microorganism and environmental management, coastal regulation zone management, acid rain, bioinformatics, fly ash. I saw the fly ash bricks. You have to popularize it. That's my second theme of today's speaking. How to popularize science and sustainable practices in the people. You have toilets. One volunteer was telling me, scientist was telling me that they went to a village where there was 100% toilets, but only 50% were being used. Others were being used for storing the wood or other things. Why? Because you have to inculcate, you have to train people, you have to, और वो इतना natural है, हम जन्म से अगर शहर में पैदा हुए हैं, तो हमें लगता है कि toilet is the natural way to defecate. एक दिन मेरे office में एक आदमी आया, उसने मुझे कहा, साहब मुझे जरा जाना है. मैंने कहा, कहाँ जाना है? मैं गांव जा रहा हूँ. क्यों? अभी तो बैठे थे, अच्छी बातें कर रहे थे. नहीं, बोले फ्री होना है. तो मैंने कहा, फ्री होना है तो अपने यहाँ टॉयलेट है. नहीं साहब, बंद में नहीं होता. तो मुझे एक नया रियलाइजेशन आया कि हम जो सोचते हैं कि हम जो करते हैं वो करेक्ट है, ऐसा नहीं है. वो भी सोच रहा है, वो भी उसका नेचुरल बाय बर्थ हैबिट है, वही वो बता रहा है कि खुले में ही होता है, बंद में नहीं होता है. तो दैट्स, you have to respect that and then change. because he has also, usko agar family ka health, bachcho ka health, is par ka impact, ye jab bataoge, jaisa abhi TV pe ad chal rahi hai, wo acha hai, ki isliye shauchalay ka prasar hoga, waise bricks hai, अभी ब्रिक्स का इतना कंसेप्ट है क्लियर लोगों के मन में कि जो माटी की ब्रिक्स है वही सबसे अच्छी है. अब ये फ्लाईएश ब्रिक है, ये करना कितना फायदे का है, वो मजबूत भी है, वो ईंट का काम ज्यादा ही अच्छा करती है और नेचर फ्रेंडली भी है, ये सब बताने की जरूरत है. दिस इज द न्यू अवेयरनेस एंड आई थिंक आवर होल मिशन ऑफ एनवीस एंड एवरीबडी एल्स इज टू क्रिएट दिस अवेयरनेस. यह अवेयरनेस के ये साधन है. द होल एग्जीबिशन इज एन एफर्ट. यू आर प्रिंटिंग न्यूज लेटर्स, यू आर ब्रिंगिंग आउट रिपोर्ट्स, यू आर पुटिंग देम ऑन वेबसाइट्स, यू आर पुटिंग देम एल्सवेयर एंड पीपल आर इंक्वायरिंग एंड पुटिंग यू क्वेश्चंस एंड यू आर आंसरिंग देम. दिस इज ऑल गुड बट दिस नीड्स टू गो टू पीपल. दैट्स पीपल सेंट्रिक. एनवीस इज अ पीपल सेंट्रिक मूवमेंट. And unless we think in these terms of a movement, ENVIS is not isolated efforts coming together annually and just taking review of what each center is doing. No, it's more than that. And therefore, I will, ab itna, when you are doing so good, dil mange more. So dil mera jo mang raha hai, wo teen cheeze hai. Pehle to ye hai, ki hamare, I was banker, so, there are banks, there are some branches A grade, some branches B grade, some branches C grade, efficiency wise, business wise, anything. You have to upgrade continuously. So you have so many ENVIS centers. You must have a plan for upgradation of each center from C to B, B to A, A to A1. That's the way upgradation is a continuous process which you must embark upon. And in 3 days workshop, I saw the timetable. It's only review of every center. But I don't know whether you are thematically discussing how the ENVIS movement will go ahead, how we will reach people more effectively, how we will network with all information dissemination, new initiatives of the government and non-government. How can we link with them? That's our, that you must discuss. If you are not planned for it, I will request you to plan 2 sessions more, because you have only 1 session, open session. No, you must have more. You can take organizational review in a short span of time, because you can give them in brochures also. But you must discuss when all these people have come here, who are volunteering, who are doing a wonderful job. The brains must meet to find a new way to reach out people more effectively. That's one. Second, raise standard, as I said. Think for big. Think big, plan big. Don't think in terms of usual budgets and usual budgetary provisions and what can we do. I asked one volunteer, how many copies you print? She said 250 copies. That's not 250 copies is too small. But you may not have 250 printed copies. But you must reach 250,000 people through websites. And website must be more clean, more attractive, more informative. But they must look nice also. I have always a problem with government websites that they don't look nice. You must have attractive websites. India is for a big leap. Modi ji, jo Bharat banana chahte hai, wo he is changing the whole system, the whole ethos of governance. And what he is aiming is it making people-centric governance and making people participate in each of activities. Earlier the system was different. Maine ek din gaya to maine ek bhashan suna Andhra Pradesh mein. Ek dusre party ke, sattarudh party ke log us samay bol rahe the. कि किसानों आप कुछ मत करो, यही से शुरुआत थी. आप कुछ मत करो, आपकी फसल आएगी तो हम खरीदेंगे, आपकी फसल नहीं आएगी तो हम कॉम्पेंसेशन देंगे, आपके माता पिताजी को पेंशन देंगे, आपके बच्चों को स्कूल का ये देंगे, यूनिफॉर्म देंगे, साइकिल देंगे, बुक देंगे, और हम सब कुछ करेंगे, आप केवल एक करो, पांच साल के बाद चुनाव आएगा तो हमें वोट दे दो, इतना ही उनका अपील था. बट दैट्स नॉट मोदी फिलोसफी. मोदी फिलोसफी इज डिफरेंट. द फिलोसफी इज दैट इन एवरी एक्शन पीपल नीड टू पार्टिसिपेट. People must come forth and our job is to induce people to participate more vigorously. So that's the change he is bringing about in the whole governance. So you must think of it and think of what ENVIS can do in this scenario. There is an initiative of HRD Ministry of e-library. They are going to connect all IIT and IIM libraries and make available free of cost to anybody. If they are doing it, my first reaction, why I can't, with this much knowledge, I will also join ENVIS as a library on the e-library. Why I can't connect? Think of some big ideas. Come out with new plan, put up before us, that this is the ENVIS for next 10 years, next 20 years. What can be the plan? Because this environmental information system is a medium of reaching out to the people, making people partner in conservation, making people partner in progress, and also ensuring sustainable development. That's the purpose, and that's what your 3-day workshop and brainstorming should bring about. Thank you, and all the best.
Once again, a warm round of applause for the Forest, Environment and Wildlife Management Department, Sikkim. Congratulations to you for winning the Best State ENVIS Center. Congratulations. And the Best Thematic ENVIS Center goes to Indian Institute of Science, Bengaluru. Congratulations to the Indian Institute of Science, Bengaluru, for winning the Best Thematic ENVIS Center. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we come to the release of ENVIS knowledge products. First, we release the books, and may I request Dr. B.S. Adhikari to kindly hand over. The WII ENVIS Center ENVIS Bulletin on Ecology Management of Grassland Habitats in India, the special ENVIS issue. So this is a soft copy and a hard copy of the same book. Bulletin on Ecology and Management of Grassland Habitats in India. It's a hard copy and as well as the soft copy of the bulletin. May I now invite Dr. Subrat Sharma, scientist in charge and head climate change from G.B. Pant ENVIS Center for the release of the State at a Glance, Jammu and Kashmir, Volume 1, 3, 2015. This is a series of States at a Glance, the ENVIS Center on Himalayan Ecology at GBPIHED has come up with this issue, which attempts to depict temporal trends through 225 tables in 15 important segments. I now invite Dr. P. Sudhakar, Coordinator CPREECC ENVIS Center, to hand over the Ecological Traditions of India, Gujarat, Volume 11. So ladies and gentlemen, Gujarat has also come home to nearly 7,000 species of plants and animals, and also provides a safe refuge to many wildlife species. And this religious religious and cultural practice of the people of Gujarat incorporate the use of many plant species and plant parts to be released. Thank you. May I now invite Dr. Arindram, coordinator, once again put your hands together for the release of the CD by WWF and the Center on the common medicinal plants of Bangalore City by FRLHT and the Center. Thank you very much indeed, sir, for doing the honors of releasing the knowledge products. Thank you, sir. Once again, let's put our hands together on the release of the
ये एनवायरमेंटली इंफॉर्मेशन सिस्टम है कि पर्यावरण के संदर्भ में लोगों को सही जानकारी मिले विभिन्न विषयों पर और इसके लिए लोगों तक पहुंचने के आसान रास्ते भी ढूंढे हैं. मोबाइल ऐप्स भी तैयार किया है एनविस का, वो जाके देखोगे तो बहुत सारी जानकारी मिलेगी. समझो एक शहर में कौन कौन से पेड़ है, कहाँ है. पंजाब ने एक बहुत ब्यूटीफुल काम किया है कि सारे ट्रीज़ कहाँ है, कौन से है, उसके गुण क्या है, सारी एक डायरेक्टरी तैयार की है. तो ऐसी सारी बहुत चीज़ें ये लोगों को जानकारी मिलेगी, रिसर्च को मिलेगी, ये इसका उद्देश्य है. और इसलिए ये 3 दिन का वर्कशॉप जो चल रहा है, देश में इतनी सारे संस्थान एनवायरमेंटल इंफॉर्मेशन सिस्टम का काम करते हैं, उसमें और कैसे सुधार होगा और उसका ज़्यादा लोगों तक कैसे पहुंच जाएंगे, इसका इसमें मंथन होगा और पर्यावरण की जागृति लोगों में पैदा हो और साथ ही साथ जो विकास होता है वो भी पर्यावरण के नुकसान के बिना कैसे हो, उसके लिए उद्योगों से लेकर सभी व्यवसायियों को भी सही मार्गदर्शन मिलने का एक प्लेटफॉर्म बनेगा. और यह ऐसी जानकारी देने वाले, रिसर्च करने वाले सभी इंस्टीट्यूट से भी तालमेल रखेगा. ये प्रयास है और ये बहुत महत्वपूर्ण प्रयास है. इसका लाभ समाज को और जो खास रुचि रखते हैं पर्यावरण के विषय में उनको होगा.